Talk about the process of getting it here.
It's exciting for me. I went through the process of negotiating a release at Top Rank, and then the most exciting fight closing the year was Manny and Marcus to go back to work with Top Rank. So that's why you do things specifically for you respect.
This business,
you
didn't exactly start from the bottom. You got a gold medalist who's 21-0. And this is a guy who's very capable of doing some big things. Obviously, you want to get past this fight on Saturday and have him look good. Beyond that, but what, starting with that, what do you want him to do? What do you expect out of him? And what do you want to do after that?
I want to put him in the exciting fights, man. Him the same, yes, the talent level. Makes him not so wishy-washy. Some fighters take the duck and dodge people. They're more difficult partners, actually, matching up people who will actually show up when it's time to actually do it. You got a lot of talent out there. You put some weight. You got Broner out there. That's the fight to watch. Adrian Broner and Ian Moore will be a fight to watch. More exciting. I think it's the new. I think it could turn into the new Floyd Mayweather, Manny Pacquiao. If they stay away from each other long enough, maybe one of those fights is anticipated as much as that fight.
We may want him back in after this. I heard February, March,
I'd like to attract to the actual sport. You know, as far as the UFC is concerned, 56% of their demo is from 15 to 34, and boxing is 30 and up, so we should actually be getting the youth involved in it.
Entertainment's a big part of that, I understand you have.
Yeah, that's what back to Adrian Broner. Right. So it's the show away from the show that makes him exciting. So when you talk like you talk, and you start backing it up, because that last fight he really went to work. You know what I'm saying? You start backing it up, then we gotta respect it. You know, and it is what it is. It's just, there's a language gap. I think you hear some of the things Gamboa is saying.
What about, I know you had made some comments that Gamboa wants to actually fight Floyd himself. Is that a legitimate goal that he has to get Floyd in the ring?
Well, he was upset. He's upset at Floyd's choices not to actually to invest after he helped him into this actual situation. You know what I mean? The initial conversations with Gamboa were between Floyd and Gamboa.
Yeah.
I came at the tail end while Floyd was actually going to jail, because he's going to go to jail. Who's going to actually provide the finances to actually make the release? So, you know, I actually took care of it while he was gone, and it turned into something that we do between me and Gamboa, and it feels like Floyd kind of, you know, left him out there. Then he calls and he doesn't want the cut man to work with him. Don't want Rafael working with him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What do you think about Pacquiao Marquez itself? What do you think about the fight? Pacquiao against Marquez?
I think it's exciting, man. It's the fourth one. It's got to be the last one, goddamn. It's the fourth one, but we want to see. You know, there's so much speculation to who won which one of those fights. And you know, Manny coming up Bradley decision. You don't want to leave it to the judges. Like, we're going to really see them in action this time. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're going to want to, in this one, I predict it doesn't go 12 rounds.
What is your, I know you're going to be a part of the entertainment on Saturday.
Yeah,
can you shed some light on that?
No,
Not too much, but you're talking about entertainment.
Not one thing. As far as entertainment is concerned, we know we're going to bring that energy that everybody is excited about when it comes time to put on the show.